Good evening, Inspired Church. How are you? Are you hungry for more of Him tonight? We're going to stand up and worship Him. It's good to see all of you here. We're here for Him. Amen. Come on, put your hands together.
How's everybody doing tonight? That is awesome. I want to lead us in prayer in just a moment, but I just want to welcome you, take a moment to just kind of let you know what we're up to tonight. We have about, I think, six more songs or so that we're going to be doing tonight. We have multiple people leading us. We're really excited about that. Can we hear it for Hannah and Erica leading us in worship tonight? It's pretty exciting stuff. You know, I'm very thankful at all of our campuses that we have wonderful people that lead us into the presence of the Lord. I'm reminded we can worship even if we're tone deaf. Amen. But I prefer this way. Just me. But I want you to raise your voice tonight. I want you to make sure that as we go into this new year that you are just welcoming Jesus into those deep places in your heart. And in just a moment, Nicole and I, and I've asked some of the leaders in the room. I see some of them. I haven't even asked yet. I'll just call them out. Like the Fadinas are here. Lynn, if you don't mind praying with people tonight. And Garrett and Tracy, if you guys are open to that, we would love to pray with you and to just lay hands on you tonight and just partner with you, because we believe that God has some incredible things in store for this year. Amen. And so I'm excited to do that. So right after I'm done praying here, Nicole and I will be over here. We'd love to pray for you and your family. Don't be shy. Just come grab us. We'd love to pray for you tonight. But why don't we join in corporate prayer? And I'm asking you to do something kind of weird. Can you join hands with the person next to you tonight? If you're comfortable with that. If you're not comfortable with that, don't worry about it. You're not like, but let's just join hands if you're around somebody tonight. And I just want to ask God to move in this place tonight in unity. Lord Jesus, we thank you for tonight. Lord, as we bow our heads, as we close our eyes, Lord, that's symbolic for us bowing our hearts before you tonight. Lord Jesus, we're not here because there's just another service, or because we're curious, or we want to hear good music. Lord Jesus, we are here tonight because we want more of you, God. Lord, I pray that tonight, God, we would not leave this place the same way that we came out. Lord, I pray that tonight, Lord Jesus, that we would engage with you, God, invite you into deeper places and spaces in our heart. And Lord, I pray, God, that you would have your way tonight. Lord, I pray for those that are hurting tonight, dealing with the weight of brokenness in our past. Lord, right now in the mighty name of Jesus, I come against the enemy of our souls. I plead the blood of Jesus over this room, over every family, over every person. Lord Jesus, thank you that one day every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Lord, we thank you that as we praise and adore you, God, that you begin to break barriers down, that you begin to break bondage. Lord, would you do that in this place tonight? Lord, we pray that as we engage in worship and even praying together a little bit later on, Lord, I pray that you would use this time, God, to set a tone in our hearts and lives for this year, God. Lord, we bless you tonight. We thank you, Jesus, that you are here in this place. Lord, again, we just bow our hearts before you, Lord. I pray that there would be an excitement and an urgency in this place, Lord. We bless you and we honor you and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, I want to encourage you, you can let each other's hands go, unless you don't want to, that's okay too. I want to encourage you, usually here at Inspire Church, no matter what campus we're on, we're usually a little clock challenged because we have multiple services and all kinds of activities and events, and all that's good stuff. There's nothing wrong with reaching more people with more services, amen? That's a good thing. But I'm always feeling like I wish I had a little bit more time to sit at Jesus's feet as a church family. And so tonight we're going to do that. So in order to do that, we're going to do things a little differently. I want to challenge you, if you're comfortable doing so, get out of your seat tonight. Come and worship out up in front. Come and worship at the altar. Let's really press in and worship Jesus tonight. Actually, maybe let's do something tonight that we wouldn't normally do. Because some of you guys are like afraid of being out of your chair. I know. Trust me, your chair will be there when you get back. Nobody will steal it. But let's get a little bit comfortable tonight. And let's get comfortable in the presence of the Lord. If you want to sit down somewhere, if you want to soak in Jesus in a different way, it's not weird. It's okay. The presence of God is in this place, and he wants to touch our hearts tonight. Amen? So I pray let's just let him do that tonight. And again, Nicole and I will be right over here to my right, your left. We'd love to pray for you. If you're watching online tonight, just crank up the music and get in a place of prayer in your home tonight. And again, guys, I'm excited that we're here tonight because I believe God's going to do some cool things tonight. So you guys ready to worship a little bit more? All right, let's do it. Take us, Erica.
All we are, and we claim your victory. Let it rise.
for fear cannot survive when we praise you. You're God of breakthroughs on our side, forever lift him high. With all creation cry, God, we praise you. Oh, come on, let your praise rise tonight. We praise you. So thankful, Jesus. Oh, we worship you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Oh, we worship you. You're so good, God. You're so good. So good to us. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. In all my days, I've been held in your hands. For the moment that I wake up, I'm gonna lay my head. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. And in darkest nights, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good.
of the goodness of God.
I will sing. Running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
And all my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so good.
Been so good.
With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. The goodness of God. Oh, I'm going to sing of the goodness of God.
I will sing, I will sing, I will sing. Yeah, I will sing.
And all my life you have been faithful. So good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God.
Inspire Church, as we continue in this atmosphere of worship in this time, God's been laying on my heart and really putting me through a season of family turmoil. Not my immediate family, but as my wife and I and my kids have grown healthier, our extended family are seeing troubles. And on top of that, new relationships has come into my life. My brother that I haven't seen in person in like 28 years, got to see him this last week. It was amazing. We got to talk for hours. And so I'm going to pray right now for the family relationships in your life and in mine. Particularly for me, siblings. My siblings and my wife's siblings. And there's relationship that we all have. Parent, child, siblings, aunts, uncles, cousins, and all that. And some of those relationships maybe in your life are broken. Maybe it's your doing. Maybe it's not. But I'm going to pray for it either way. Will you join me as we pray for that? Lord, You're so good and you're so faithful, and you've created us in a way that allows us to build families. Lord, you said, be fruitful and multiply. And we multiply through families. And our families are father, mother, children. And yet, that's rarely the story. It's blended families and broken relationships and brothers and sisters that don't get along even from the beginning of time. Cain and Abel had sibling rivalry. And God, I know in this room there are broken relationships amongst family. And I pray that this year, this season even, Lord, that you would help us as individuals and collectively as a church to begin the steps of restoring those relationships. God, that we would have the hard conversations, that we would be willing to tell the truth in love, as we've learned over and over again from messages in this church, from messages in your word. Lord, we want to tell the truth and we want to be loving. Lord, help us to hear the truth in love in the areas we haven't heard it well. God, if we're the ones that need to lay down some things and lay down some pride and lay down some past hurts, Lord, help us to begin that healing process. Lord, I pray for all the sibling relationships in this room, whether it's biological siblings, adopted siblings, blended family siblings. God, I pray that you would restore relationships that are broken, that you would help relationships that have flourished lately grow even more. God, I want restoration in those things. I think you want that too. We don't want to have hurt in our hearts so that causes us to hurt others, but we want to be healthy in those ways. Lord, I pray for the relationships between parents and children of whatever age, Lord. Even those of us who have hurt from parents that are no longer alive, Lord. Help us to begin that healing process. God, you're a redeemer. Yeah. And you take broken things and you make them great things. You take dirt and make good out of the dust. You take ashes and you make beauty. Your word says that you do all that, and we trust that. And Lord, there's dozens and dozens of stories in this room, and it takes a lot of steps to get to healing. God, you're in it all. Thank you for putting this season into my life of getting to reconnect with my half-brother who I love and I care about. I pray that you'd help us to connect even more over the next months and years. Help the difficult relationships that I have in my life and amongst family and extended family, Lord. I pray that you'd help us, my family, navigate all of those things and help us to seek you in all of it and point our family toward Jesus and help us to make sure that we're navigating it all out of following you and not out of our own emotion. Thank you for putting this on my heart, Lord. I love you, God. I really do. And I'm glad to follow you, even when it's hard. I'm thankful. Bless the rest of tonight as we continue to sing to you and worship you and pray to you. We love you, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's continue to sing together, Inspire.
the goodness of God.
It's running after me.
We will sing it.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running. The goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God.
We will sing. We will sing. You're so good.
I'm calling on the God of Jacob, whose love endures through generations. I know that you will keep your covenant. I'm calling on the God. Come on, let your faith rise up. We know who we're singing to. Open up the ocean. Yes, we need. I need you now to do the same thing.
Come on, if you need that miracle in your life and you know who you're singing to tonight, the same God of the Bible. Come on, lift it up.
Yeah. Oh God, my God, I need you. Oh God, my God, I need you now. How I need you now. Yeah. Oh rock of ages, I'm standing on your faithfulness. On your faithfulness.
It's who we're standing on. Sing it up.
I'm calling on the God of Mary, whose favor rests upon the lowly. I know with you all things are possible.
Come on, remind your heart and soul tonight.
I'm calling on the God of David, made a shepherd boy courageous. I may not face Goliath, but I've got my own giant. Oh God, my God, I need you. Oh God, my God, I need you now. How I need you now.
He's the only one we need.
Oh rock, oh rock.
Standing on your faithfulness, on your faithfulness, yeah. Oh God, my God, I need you.
Oh God, my God. You heard your children then. You hear your children now. You are the same God. You are the same God. You answered prayers back then, and you will answer now. You are the same God.
Come on.
Yeah, yeah. You were providing then. You are providing now. You are the same.
He's the same.
You're the same God. You are.
Come on, just lift your worship to Him today.
You're the same God. You are, you are. It's who we worship. We need you more. Yeah. I'm calling on the Holy Spirit. Almighty river, come and fill me again. Come in, come and fill me again right now. Come and fill me again. Come and fill us up, Lord. Fill us up.
More of you, Lord. We want more of you.
You are who we love. We love you. We love you, Jesus. I love you more every day, every day. Oh, the Savior nailed to wash our feet.
Come on.
Now at his feet we bow.
How we bow to you.
The one who wore our sin and shame, now robed in shines for all to see.
Yes, you do, yeah.
Your name is victory. All praise will rise.
Come on now. Sing it out.
Your name is victory. All praise. That healed us now gives way.
Come on.
To him who is our peace. His final breath upon the cross is now alive in me. Yes, it is.
Come on, rise up. Rise up and worship. Come on.
The resurrect is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King
is resurrecting me.
By your spirit.
Come on, we rise from the ashes. Rise up from deep down.
His body there would not remain. Our God has robbed the grave.
Come on, let that rise up. Our God has robbed the grave. Yes, he has. Our God has robbed the grave. He's paid the price. He's risen and living in love.
Your name is victory. All praise will rise.
Come on, sing it out. All praise will rise. He wants to hear us sing. Come on, worship him. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Jesus. Oh, we worship you. Our God is alive. Our God is alive. Yay, yay. Thank you, Jesus. Our God, He lives in me. So thankful for you. Jesus, Jesus, your name is victory. Jesus, for your presence, for your sweet, sweet presence. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Ooh. God, you are so good. God, we worship you. Have your way in this place, God.
Whatever you want to
These are big words we're singing. You can't just sing it. We have to mean it in our hearts. What we're asking him to do is big. Shake up the ground of all I'm used to, of what I do every day, every Sunday, every week. Break down the walls. So as we sing this, remember, if you're inviting him in, get ready for something. Because God wants to fill us up. He wants to move us and shake us and line us up with what he has in store for us, church. And I know it's good, because every good and perfect thing comes from him. So if you're sitting here feeling stuck, you need to ask him to shake up that ground, to break down those walls and put our trust in him. And when we sing these words, things happen. When we're in worship, we're in God's presence, things happen. We are not just singing a song, right? So tonight, as we sing this, I get so excited when I sing this, and I know it's kind of scary too, because I don't know what he's gonna do. but to shake us up. To shake us up and break down those walls so we can have freedom to worship Him, to live our lives the way He wants us to do, to move forward, amen? To shake up the people around us. So as you sing this out, be bold and ask Him to come and do something new in your life tonight. That's gonna go out tomorrow and the next day, because as we move and we shake and we line ourselves up with what Jesus has, people around us notice. We are lighthouses. It's a big responsibility, but it's a good one. So tonight, if you're ready to make that step to move forward and really allow Him to break down those walls, to shake up the ground that you're used to standing on, ask Him to do it and He will. I believe, yes You are. He's already working now, yeah. Oh, we worship You, yeah. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Come on, sing it out. Your way is better, yeah. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better, Jesus. Your way is better, yeah. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Come on, ask Him to come in and make something new tonight. Your way is better. Oh, won't You shake up the ground of all my tradition? Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better, yeah. Your way is better. Come on, sing it one more time. Shake it up. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Whatever You want to, whatever You want, we're open now. I will make room for You every day to do whatever You want to, whatever You want to. I will make room for You, Jesus. Do whatever You want to, whatever You want to, yeah. I will make room for You alone. To do whatever You want to, whatever You want to. Here is where I lay it down. Every burden, every crown. This is my surrender. This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down. Every lie and every. This is my surrender. I will make room. We make room for You to move, Jesus, yeah. Love, love. I will make room. Oh, we wait on You. Whatever You want to, whatever You want to, I will make room.
Come on, church, let's sing this from the bottom of our hearts now. Let's make some room tonight. Yes, Jesus, we make room in this place tonight, God. Lord, we don't want to be so full of ourselves that we miss out on what you have, God. Lord, we're not in a hurry. Lord, even if we're tired tonight, God, we just want you to do what only you can do, God. I will make room for you, Jesus, to do whatever you want to. Thank you, Lord.
Whatever you want to.
So we make room in this place tonight, Lord.
I will make room for you, my Lord, to do whatever you want to. Whatever you want to.
Thank you, Jesus. You know, friends, I just feel like tonight something that well, first I'll say, I don't mean to interrupt the spirit of worship, but today you guys honored Nicole and I for 5 years of ministry, and we're so thankful that you honored us, but not on top of that, we're so thankful that God aggressively interrupted our lives to come here 5 years ago, because it was an aggressive interruption. It was years, probably a full year of frustration and pain of God having to slap me upside the head and get my attention, while at the same time shifting things here. And one of the things that I learned in that season that's just on my heart to share with you tonight is that I think it many times in my life, me being worried about what other people thought, my pride of being worried about not being good enough because of the trauma from my past and the things I've been through, kept me from so many breakthroughs that God had for my life. As a matter of fact, I would say Nicole and I struggled in our first 5 years of marriage, let's say it's not plural, singular. In our first 5 years of marriage, we struggled more than we should have because of my pride. And because I was so worried about trying to be the best and be something that I could prove my dad wrong and prove my grandmother wrong and prove these people that said terrible things about me. And can I just say, one of the things that I've seen in being here for the last 5 years is that there is, spiritually, there's something that hovers over this region that says, let's keep everybody out and let's build walls up and let's not be transparent with each other. I don't know what it is, and I 5 years is long enough for me to say it like it is, right? Can I say that tonight? I feel like I've been here long enough to now go, hey, I really genuinely see this, and I just want to challenge you tonight that we're not going to spend another hour. I mean, maybe, I don't know, let's see what Jesus does, but we're going to go back and we're going to sing about the goodness of God here in a moment. And I want to challenge us tonight. Don't leave anything on the table tonight. Because again, I can't even explain to you how much I think in seasons of my life I left on the table because I was too proud to humble myself and get on my face before God and admit to people around me that I was broken and that I needed help. Friends, if you're in that place tonight, look at somebody around you, ask them for prayer tonight, be transparent, be open. Tonight might be the night of breakthrough for you, where you can just say it like it is, the thing that you're struggling with, the emotions that you're feeling, and you can ask God for help with that tonight. Don't allow the walls that we like to build up to keep you from getting to the breakthrough that God has right on the other side. Amen? That's what tonight is about. It's about breakthrough. Amen? So would you sing with us tonight about the goodness of God? Hannah, I believe you led that song. Would you lead us again in that song? Thank you.
All my life you have been so, so good.
The goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God.
I'm singing of the goodness of God.
the goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God.
Father God, Lord, thank you for who you are. God, thank you for meeting us tonight, for moving in this place, God, for meeting needs, for mending hearts, for putting things back together, God, for allowing us to just come and sit and praise and cry and seek you. God, thank you for being so tremendously good to us. God, represented in this room and watching online and all over the world are people that don't deserve your love and don't deserve your grace, and yet you gave it to us anyway. And God, for that we are so, so thankful. God, thank you for being so, so good. So good, God. Lord, I pray that as we enter into 2024, that we will take what started tonight and continue to chase after you, God, that tonight won't be just a moment, just something that maybe we think back on, something that made us feel good one time and nothing ever again, but God, that this can be a catalyst moment, a change in our relationship with you. God, you are alive and you are moving, you are healing and you are real. God, you are amazing. God, I don't know what the needs are represented in this place. I don't know what the hurts are, what the pains are, but God, you do. God, you know the victories of 2023. You saw our highest moments. And God, you also know the defeats. You know the deaths. You know the pain. God, you know the losses. And even in our lowest and in our darkest, God, you are still there holding us. Lord, when we run, you chase after us. God, it is so humbling how much you love us. Thank you. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for what you're doing. God, we love you, and we pray these things in your name. Amen. 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 At this point, I'm going to be super honest with you guys. The worship team, we're out of worship songs. We've done a lot of worship songs. I think we're going to end the live stream here. We're not kicking anybody out. We're going to kind of transition what we're doing here. One of us, me or Erica, we're going to stick around. We're going to play some music. Take as long as you need. You don't need to leave. We're not kicking you out. I'm going to pray for us one more time. I'm also going to take just a moment here. There was something that was on my heart tonight, and I know that this is going to sound odd. I know that this is going to sound like a very pastory thing to do, but this is something that has been bugging me the entire time we've been worshiping, and I'm sorry, but I'm going to do it. I feel like God is pushing me to do this. When we get into a new year, we start to think about diets. We start to think about losing weight. We start to think about all of the ways that we could improve ourselves. Maybe for some of you, you sat down and you found a Bible reading plan. Maybe you left with that fancy piece of paper that said, this is how you can read the Bible over the course of the year. And all of those things are great. To worry about your health, to worry about your mental health, to worry about your relationship with Jesus. All of those things are great. All of those things are life-changing, some more than others. One of the things I want to challenge you to think about as we step into this new year and into this new season is your giving. My life was changed in indescribable ways when I turned my money over to God. And this whole time we've been playing and we've been singing, this has been, you ever get nervous because God is telling you to do something? You're like, God, I don't know if now is the time or the place to do something like that. You're like, I'm either gonna be sick or I'm gonna make it through these words. That's how I felt all night long with this.